Unstoppable. With the surge of a new launch's powerful vehicle upgrades and exciting expansions at Starbase, Starship is one of the brink of a revolutionary era. The latest updates from the FAA are pushing the boundaries of what's possible for this game-changing rocket. Meanwhile, the Starliner spacecraft has yet to make a return and despite several attempts future missions face growing uncertainty, get ready to dive into these thrilling developments on today's episode of SpaceX Saga. That's right, Starship is set to play a pivotal role in our future, whether it's landing on the moon or colonizing Mars. But to make these ambition goals a reality, Starship must continue to advance following four successful flights and impressive achievements of two stage landings. Progress is well underway. On July 12, the FAA made a significant announcement revealing they are considering a proposal to increase the number of launches and landings for Starship and Super Heavy at Boca Chica, Texas. The maker of the reusable spacecraft in the form of Starbase and upgrade outlined necessary upgrades to the vehicle and the landing site and hinted with a future target of 25 launches and landings. Then July 29, the FAA providing another update public input they announced on X. We want to hear from the FAA released a draft environmental assessment from SpaceX proposal to increase the number of the operations of its Starship SL Super Heavy vehicle in a Boca Chica, Texas. In addition to the actual announcements, the FAA released a comprehensive 154-page document titled Triad Environmental Assessment from the SpaceX Starship SLS Super Heavy Vehicle Insert at SpaceX Boca Chica launch site, the Camonon Country, Texas. This document outlined four key upgrades. Firstly, regarding the number of the launches, SpaceX proposal aim of 25 launches and 50 landings per year makes sense, right? Because when it launches, it's just one item. But when it lands, if two ambitions target highlighted the continued importance of the achieving successful two-stage landing of the company. This proposal aligns with the FAA recent upgrades and the make significant increase from the FAA 2020-22 era environmental assessment of the P report, with the initially permitted only 5 missions per year of the Starbase. SpaceX already launched from Starship missions last year of 2, this year with a pivotal 5th mission of Flight 5 of the Horizon, with the upcoming months looking ahead as a SpaceX workers towards the critical goals with such developments, the refueling system successfully catching post stage with the main mechanism arm and advanced the human landing system on HLS or NASA Artemis missions. The need to the higher frequency of launches become evidence of the 25th flight license will be stationed to meet these ambition objectives and supports future of space explorations following the upgrades on launch frequency. SpaceX has also announced some impressive upgrades of these rockets in 2020-22. Environmental assessment, Starship has declared 50m tall, vehicle 9m in diameter, with 6 engines capable of carry 1,500 metric tons of fuel and generating 12 mega on thrust. Super Heavy on the other hand, and 71 meter tall, also 9 meter in diameter, with 37 engines and 3,700 metric tons of fuel, producing a formidable 74 mega newtons of the thrust of the SpaceX is taking things to the next level. The new Starship will grow to the 70 meter in height, keeping the same 9 diameter, but with an increased number of the engines, 9 in total, it will carry 2,650 metric tons of fuel and generate a powerful 28.7 meters of the thrust. When these upgrades from the combined height of the Starship and Super Heavy will reach 150 meter, these advancements respects and a submittal boost in the aligned closely with the specifications outlined in the FAA environmental impact statement of this future operation. Now let's turn on the attention on the Starbase expansion, and the recent FAA layout provides detailed insights to both the current and the future developments areas, and the site is highlighting and exciting facilities including the current launch structures which elegant, with the starboard present confusing and the expansion of the second launch tour, looking toward the FAA plan outlines significant truth and the launches as well expand future days expanding behind the current suborbital tank form system. This expansion is likely aimed at achieving the fuel infrastructure. To support the new launch tower under construction, the layout also introducing new structures, mod and notable violet in color, which include additional fuel tanks, warehouses, and fuel lines. Overall, these developments are geared toward boosting SpaceX capabilities to meet their ambition goal of 25 launches annually. The FAA document also details new pivotal landing areas. In addition, the Gulf of Mexico new landing zones are planned in the Pacific Ocean, specifically the northeast Pacific near the California coast, in the southeast Pacific off the west coast in the South America. Also, a proposed area in the Indian Ocean spanning from the eastern majestic of the eastern coast of Australia, avoiding inhabited islands. Regarding the Indian Ocean, it's notable. This is where Starship S-29 landing during Flight 4 in a future SpaceX might explore landing options close to Australian coast. To the plan involves start of making a controlled landing on a drone ship following the towing and a vehicle in the main line, similar to the current Falcon 9 operation. This approach not only offers logistical convenience but also between SpaceX and Australia is various aspects. FAA current proposal is still undergoing a thorough review process, including a public meeting scheduled for August. Following this, are several additional steps before the proposal can receive final proposal website. These ongoing reviews are significant updates from the FAA draft environmental assessment indicate positive progress. The FAA consolidation. This optimism, the FAA are determined or the modification of SpaceX exciting vehicle operator license for Starship Super Heavy operations. Algons with the superior environmental documentation consists with the data in 2022 paper are no significant environmental changes and the all maintenance conditions and the requirements. And the requirements of the previous approval has been met to while met in the current situation. In the FAA current step is successfully resolved, the path ahead will likely to smooth the draw of a new era of Starship is fast approaching, where large Starship will be launched more frequently from the advanced facilities and land in diverse locations. And exciting about this, so comments here below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel to keep up with SpaceX development journey. Next, let's turn to the latest update on the Starliner and previously mentioned Boeing's team planned to conduct a test for the Starliner system on July 27. This test involved the Spacecraft Reactions Control System, or RCS, thrust and the critical steps in the preparing from the upcoming reviews in assess spacecraft readiness of the landing. NASA astronauts Wilmore and Sonny Wilson expected in August, providing all goals are planned. Boeing recently shared the result of this test. According to this blog post, the new RS test aimed to confirm the performance to each thrust from the brief burst of up to 1.2 seconds each out of 28 thrust excellent from the test due to the previous issues and the remaining thrust peak thrust ranging 97% to 102, confirming their performance within the expected range. Boeing also noted the helium system remains stable. However, Wilmore and Wilson did not directly engage the thrust during the test. Instead, they stayed on the board Starliner observing and reporting back in the ground control. Both and seasoned U.S. Navy test pilots with extensive experience on the development aerospace programs. Recent ground tests revealed critical issues with the CFTS RCS, specifically when the thrusts are defeated, particularly alongside the suborbital. Meanwhile, the control system on the thrust in the include be housing the RCS thrust, also known dog houses, tend to the overheat. This overheating causes and the Teflon insulation on the thrust seals to the degrade. According to NASA and Boeing, this problem could not have been anticipated during ground testing before the CFT flight. Unfortunately, this development doesn't bring to end on the Starliner delays. NASA officials stated on the X teams will evaluate the result of the test fairings over the next few days as these works throw overall studies ahead of all agencies. These reviews from both NASA and Boeing are still dreaming how to address the Starliner issues, whatever. Through design modification on changing and operational of the astronaut trust engaged, Starliner 1 mission has postponed on August on next year, a shift from the previously expected early winter launch before they can even think about Starliner 1. However, NASA and Boeing must first address an ongoing safety mission originally sought from the 10 days during the mission has now expanded to nearly 55 days in space. That's almost 2 months. The astronauts Mitch Fillmore and Sonny Wilson are currently relying on their research supplies aboard the ISS, which we pre-resolved the 4-month Boeing's to affect both current and the future mission, rising concerns about the Butch and the Sonny Wilson return, whether they will be able to do so safely at this point. One might wish for a Dragon to reuse. Resume these are bring home regarding Starliner and previously as asked whether Crew 10 or Starliner 1 will launch first. Now with Crew 10 being replaced by Crew 11, which do you think will launch first? Let me know this idiot on 11 in the comment section and down below. Well folks, that about this today episode. Thank you so much for tuning, and this is always has been Kevin from SpaceX Saga, and until next time, keep looking up.